What happened?
We're not kicking him out. I know a lot of you guys were afraid of that, and I understand why, considering the last time of what happened. But he is not leaving. But if you think that I wasn't ready to do it, you're out of your damn mind. You could ask Maya. I was literally crying. I thought I was going to have to do it.
Espresso alien PLS Roberto D'Espresso alien PLS Roberto D'Espresso alien PLS Roberto D'Espresso alien PLS.
But he is getting help. He is going to talk to somebody. He is going to change his behavior. He is going to...
That's the drama you want to skip? No, Cap, what happened?
Like, not genuine. But he really does want to be better. Like, he doesn't want to make people uncomfortable. He's going to change himself so that he doesn't do that. Because this was a lot. This was more than a wake-up call. This was like... Yeah, so... There you go.
We're not...
Grooming? Wait, sexual harassment? What the fuck? Wait. Adriana Leon Novru pretending to care about her allegations when she didn't before? FaZe Banks tweeted, is it like Adriana Lee already had 5 friends with her when CrazySlick was trying to check up on her? What is it? Complicated and not? Slick was creepy with a girl about a party a year ago. Like, what are we talking? Are we talking fucking... Are we talking like he was... Like, creepy as in, like, he did assault someone? Or are we talking he was just, like, creepy? Because he's, like, not good. He was doing stuff to a blackout drunk girl? My experience with CrazySlick... by Adriana Lee. I never thought I'd be making one of these, but here we are. I was a girl at Novru who was talking about in the clip on LSF, link below. On January 19th on 2020, I went to Novru's 21st birthday party because I went with some of my closest friends. I believed it would be safe for me to enjoy myself. Got very intoxicated and ended up blacked out. Leading the rest of the story, what I've heard from multiple witnesses and how I feel about it. I was told that I was kissing my best friend, Anna, and another one of my close friends at the time, consensually. CrazySlick was following us around, trying to kiss her, and at one point, I was told that he and I ended up kissing. Then apparently I was passed out in one of the rooms of the party and he came into the room while I was unconscious. He came into the room a couple times after being asked to leave me alone each time. 2 of those instances, he touched my neck and chest saying he was just making sure I was alive after being assured by my friends that I was okay as they were watching over me. Whether or not his intentions were out of genuine concern or not, I do not know. To be clear, he did not rape me or assault me, but his actions did make me uncomfortable. All I can say is how I feel after the story. I woke up to the text of a friend I just met that weekend. I'm very grateful to have my friends that kept me safe because I feel as though if there was honestly no telling what would have happened if they were not there. Someone who's been taken advantage of for my sexuality and for being drunk in the past, this reinforced a lot of trauma for me. Knowing that he found Anna and I making out hot and tried to get something out of it is something that made me very uncomfortable. I can't clarify any facts or even say what happened because I was blackout drunk and then unconscious. Me and Slick never talked like that. He would say weird things in my chat and my friend's chat and even try to get my friends to get me and him in a phone call together. As for Nova, she had me blocked before today for whatever reason. Nova had no right to air my trauma on her stream, and when she wasn't even in the room to help, let alone see what happened, I had to cancel all my plans today because of the stress it brought on me and being pressured to talk about something I was not ready and afraid to talk about. She unblocked me to tell me she talked about my story and my other close friend's story on stream, and for what? It was not her place to talk about my story and trauma live on her stream. Oh my God. She's like ripping into Novru more than fucking Slick, dude. What the fuck? Sorry, not to laugh. I'm not. This is very serious. It is serious. I'm not. But it's like 3 paragraphs about what Novru did. She replied to her own tweet, acting like she was doing me a favor airing this out. Yeah, it does. It is fucked up, by the way. I understand that. She was doing me a favor airing this out. If she truly... cared, she would have reached out to me before she went on stream to talk about it. I agree. Other girls should be aware of what happened, but it was not her place to do it for me. Nova brought out my story to justify her opinion on Slick on John Zerka's stream. Seeing how often she is in drama to me, it just feels like it was another way to try and seem irrelevant by virtue signaling and pretending she's doing this for the greater good. Okay. She was unconscious, yet she felt uncomfortable. No, she's saying she felt uncomfortable afterwards, after she was relayed the events that took place. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Here is a good rule of thumb. You are not at liberty to discuss someone else's fucking trauma. Don't do that. That's not good, okay? Especially if they themselves did not feel comfortable talking about it. What the fuck are you doing? That's one. Two, don't touch women that are fucking blackout drunk. And don't be fucking creepy. And if your friends are being creepy, check them, okay? Yeah, when a girl's really drunk, just don't make any moves the gentleman way. Exactly, okay? So it's weird and all, but why is it the front page of LSF? I don't know, because it's like... If you saw this, what would you do? I would fucking talk to CrazySlick. 1,000%. Like, absolutely. All the comments were defending Slick because LSF commenters, well, one, she's not even saying he was, like, raped. She was raped. She's saying she felt uncomfortable by it because he was being fucking creepy. I don't know why the fuck people are devaluing that. It's not like she herself, wait, hold on. Thank you for this. It's not like she's saying that he's, like, a fucking... She's not even making him out to be the biggest villain here. She's, like, more upset about what Nova did than Slick did. Antifa and Mizkif sponsor, a little sussy, what? Anyway. There were commenters saying he didn't do anything wrong, which is not true. No, he did. He did do something wrong, okay? But there is a thing, look, I think a lot of people who do not have the narrative that incels on LSF are trying to spread right now is that since Adriana says she didn't give consent to CrazySlick, then that also means she couldn't give consent to her best friend to kiss her. Dumb fucks don't realize that she knowingly went to a party with her best friend, so she can give consent a priori, especially if she's done this in the past. She doesn't know Slick and never met him before. They aren't slash weren't friends. Yeah, but then incels will say, oh, well, what about your boyfriends that, like, you know, rape their girlfriends or something, like, oh, well, you know, feminists will say that's real, but it seems like you're wrong on that or some shit like that. Listen, guys. It doesn't really matter what weirdos and LSF are saying. I think that a lot of people probably see themselves in what CrazySlick did. What CrazySlick did, luckily, as a consequence of whether this girl's friends were around her or for a multitude of different factors, or because CrazySlick also personally has at least some boundaries. I don't know. Maybe, to be as charitable as possible, was not as bad as it could have been, okay? Even though it does feel, it's sus. And CrazySlick's tweet longer. I'm incredibly sorry for making Adriana feel uncomfortable at a party a year ago. Very sorry that her friends are tonight for having to put up with me. I was drunk and anxious, and my intentions were to check her pulse because I was worried. I realized that I was overstepping, and it should have... Okay. I realized that I was overstepping, and I should have let her friends take care of her. There's no excuse for my behavior. I hope that she can forgive my actions. I'm also deeply sorry for anyone else that's ever made uncomfortable, whether it be on stream, at a party, or anywhere else. It's been never my intention to make people feel scared or uncomfortable. I feel awful that I caused this. I'm sorry. Okay, so checking on people is sus. I mean, I don't, like, not to pull a JCS here, but, like, if he was just checking on her, then why is he apologizing? You know what I mean? It's like when you, checking a pulse is, like, weird too, but, if someone is checking, no, because he made her uncomfortable, no, but, like, what you would normally say in a situation like this is, okay, I had no fucking clue that this was unacceptable, what I was doing, and you would be way more, you would be, you know, defending your actions. If She's the other creepy stuff she mentioned about wanting to kiss her. Exactly. And if it's like, oh shit. And if you're like trying to kiss someone like that, then you're probably not just checking on their pulse, especially when there's five other girls in the room with them. You just stop watching JCS. She said she had multiple friends around her. Why would he feel the need to go in and touch her just to check on her? Yeah, I know. DMs from other girls showed he did say at the time he was checking if she was alive. You can apologize for unintentionally making someone uncomfortable. I don't see if it's personally, but I get your argument. You may have been drunk as shit as well. Not to excuse, but explain the apology. Like, this is, I mean, it's bad. His actions are bad. Not like, not the absolute worst from what I understand. You know what I mean? Like, it could have been significantly worse. It's just weird. It's gross. But, not so bad that he has to get jacked and get a dog yet. I don't think so, but. It's tough since there's the implication that something worse could have happened if her friends weren't even there. Yeah, but it didn't happen. So. And also beyond that, like. I don't really know CrazySlick. Does he have like a history of doing this sort of stuff to girls? Because usually when this shit happens, like, there is more of a pattern. An instance like this is never enough to just like fucking, you know. When we look at a story like this, when we look at a case like this, what we're looking for is the intention, right? Like, we're looking at the intention. Being weird at a party while drinking equals serial rapist. No one is saying that he's a serial rapist. So, the point that people are trying to find, whether they're defending CrazySlick or criticizing CrazySlick's actions, is like, was the intention behind what CrazySlick was doing motivated by him being drunk and unaware of like how to act around girls? Even if it was genuine, okay? Or was the intention that he was, like, trying to cop a feel and be weird and creepy and do so by taking advantage of a drunk person, right? That's the question. That's what you're trying to figure out. Mizkif talks about this Slick situation.
So, in her doing that, I'm so sorry. Everybody is so sorry to her that she had to go through that because it's so unfair. But what she said in that statement, he said that what Slick did was inexcusable, and that's true because Slick made people uncomfortable. Even though it wasn't his intention, he made people uncomfortable, you know? And he came across as creepy, which is not okay, and he doesn't want to make people uncomfortable. So he needs to take accountability for that, and he is taking accountability for that. But the whole situation yesterday was just super, super unfortunate. But the important thing that she said in her statement and the reason that Slick is staying here and having the opportunity to take that accountability is because Slick was creepy and made people uncomfortable, but he did not assault anybody and he did not rape anybody. Which I think a lot of people made the assumption that he did after the clip from Novaru yesterday. So.
A lot of butts up in that apology. No, but I mean, I don't know why you guys are. I don't know why you guys are saying that. Definitely assault. I mean. Another instance of crazy, like being creepy and making people feel uncomfortable.
So.
Streamers will protect anyone. Dude, you guys are fucking insane, dude. I'm sorry. Listen. Chat, I know that you don't do a lot of social interactions, but you're fucking nuts if you think that, like, what happened here, whether it was because of other factors or not, but what happened here beyond, like, creepy behavior, it goes beyond creepy behavior. Like, chat will literally defend anything. What do you want him to do, fucking kill the dude? Like, I don't understand. Streamers literally acting like Republicans protecting Kavanaugh. You think what Kavanaugh did is the same? Are you guys fucking nuts? Bro, what the fuck, dude? What the fuck is wrong with people, dude? Yo, please stop. Please stop. You make people fucking take an even more reactionary approach. Like, you sound like the fucking LSF incels that get mad on my behalf when women say sexualized things about me, dude. If the person herself is not saying that it's assault, then what the fuck is it up to you, dude? Holy shit. You're like, nah, it doesn't matter.
Here's my hot take on CrazySlick. Don't really know this person at all, but they were in my chat. And according to this, I think you guys can see this, maybe? I'm just going to post the link so you guys can fucking click on it yourself. I don't know if you can see it or not, but that is that. And he was in my chat and he said, "What the fuck? Fuck you. Good morning. You seem cool. Have good morning, dog." LMAO.
Shut the fuck up for 1 minute, I beg you. You keep saying the same things wrong over and over for hours. What? 15-month subscriber comes into streamer's chat to tell streamer to shut the fuck up. Like, what a psychotic fucking take, dude. Are you okay? Is your brain all right? Are you functioning properly? Litter de class A? You good? What's happening, dude? Being drunk should never be an excuse for being creepy. If he can't handle himself, he needs to go to rehab or get locked up. Get locked up? I'm so confused by all of this shit. Are people spending $5 to decrease their chance of getting perma for their stupid takes? I'm just waiting on a response from this person. You keep using the same straw man? Okay. This is a, in my opinion, this, without any additional evidence of, like, repeat behavior from CrazySlick or anything like that, this in and of itself is a borderline case that falls within the gray area. Even if he is, like, even if he's being fucking weird and actually touched a drunk person inappropriately, whether it be their chest or pulse, I don't know what the exact details are, and neither does she. Unfortunately, she was blacked out. Okay? This, in and of itself, is not, like, enough to fucking throw people in jail, dude. What are you talking about? Are you guys nuts, dude? Him trying to kiss this girl, whether because he's personally drunk or because, you know, for whatever the reason is, him trying to kiss this girl is creepy as fuck. That paired up with him inappropriately touching a blacked out drunk person, claiming that he's just doing it because he wants to figure out whether she is alive or not is additionally creepy as fuck. Okay? But, like, wanting to throw someone in jail over that is psychotic. There's a fucking huge discrepancy. But what we're talking about is some sort of physical assault. There's no straw man there. Didn't they consensually make out? I don't know what the fucking details are. She says she was drunk. She doesn't remember it. So she can't have, she can't be fucking giving consent regardless. She said he did kiss her. Yes. Yes. Why are you surprised your audience is cringe lefties? She said she consensually made out with her friend, which was still kind of a strange thing to add. Like, I don't personally think he literally thought she was dead, dude. I don't think that he thought this person was dead, and that's why he was checking in on her, okay? And also, when you're checking in on a drunk person, you don't fucking, if she can't consent to a kiss and it's sexual assault, why do you keep minimizing it? Because if he's also drunk, you are assuming that he's, like, doing this with malintent, okay? There are certain things that you do in situations like this where automatically assuming that, like, he fucking went in, creeped on her, and, like, did this with malintent is not my immediate fucking immediate response. You think he didn't know she wouldn't do that shit sober? Dude, she's saying she wasn't assaulted, Chatters. She's saying she was not raped or assaulted. What the fuck do you want? So if you're also drunk, it's fine. I'm confused. No. If you're also drunk, it's fine is not the argument that I'm making here. But interpersonal relationships between two people, especially if you're getting romantic or physical, can sometimes be misconstrued, okay? If you're at a party and you're drunk and you think this other girl is into you because you're a fucking dumbass and have no social awareness, I think that, like, as long as there isn't repeat offenses, That in and of itself is not enough to be like, this person is fucking horrible. This person is a monster. This person needs to fucking go to jail or whatever the fuck. Now, obviously, that's only because we're having a conversation around like two people with the other person, whether it was a consequence of other reasons, like the friends being there or not, this person just checked in on the other girl. Okay. If they had done something more than that, then it would be a little bit easier to fucking say it doesn't matter if this is a singular instance. It's still completely unacceptable. Okay? Whew. Does that make sense? You really believe he was checking her pulse? No. I don't know what happened, but I think he probably wanted to wake her up. You know what I mean? He probably wanted to do more. We don't know. Luckily, nothing more happened. Okay? Stop making assumptions like everyone else. I mean, yeah, that's pure speculation on my end.
We're like Hasan. I know you're going to say that, because Hassan's good looking. Would it really matter if this happened? It doesn't make a difference, dude. It's just Hasan understands right from wrong in these situations and what to do and what not to do. And that's partially why Hasan gets laid so much, is because he understands these things.
I would not do that, what CrazySlick did. I would not.
He's aware of the situations. You know, he's not aware of how much he pauses his videos, but he's unaware of what.
Oh, you fucking asshole.
What's going on around him and how to interact with other women. You know? We're like Hasan.
Like this video, please subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss out on any future videos.